What has been the coolest thing about this project?
I get to put sharks in wind tunnels. Like, who else can say that? Who else can say that here at OSU? The main problem that we're kind of like tackling is conservationists and scientists, they use satellite tracking tags to monitor sharks. Problem is these tags impose a decent amount of drag and it makes it hard for the animal to swim and they expend more energy. So we're ultimately trying to create a model where scientists can simulate new tag designs before sticking them on a shark. So we took very high fidelity 3D models generated from photo scans and videos from a company that does the same with the different species. We took those models and we threw them into StarCCM Plus, and we ran simulations of the sharks swimming at their cruising speeds. And then in parallel, we also took those same models and 3D printed them scaled down so we could toss them into our wind tunnel here at the Graff Hall Research Lab. So we did a few different methods. These blue models here printed out of ABS plastic on a 3D printer. These gray ones, however, these were courtesy of the HP office just outside of town. This is a PA12 nylon powder printed shark. The main appeal of the project was just how out of the box it was. Being able to apply 3D printing as well as fluid dynamics modeling and wind tunnel testing in a very unique way. So the wind tunnel here, it is kind of unique. Some wind tunnels, they actually have a fan in the front. This one has a fan in the back. After loading our sting mount in, which has strain gauges to collect data, we mount the shark, close up the tunnel, and then we set the fan to a certain speed and it pulls air through the front here and all the way into the back, pulling it against the shark itself and then that pulling the sting mount, and then we can get data from there. So working with people kind of outside of our department has been really, really cool because we don't know everything. We didn't know anything about sharks really going into this, like, you know, their behavior, their speeds, their sizes. And so reaching out to experts in other fields really, really helped, because then we can kind of fill in the gaps and then we could try to like get a common vocabulary going and just really kind of expand outside of just our specific field.